Hi Blender fans and welcome to Blender TZ. In today's tutorial we'll be making the jam of our jam tarts. In last time's tutorial we made the pastry, and join me at the end of the tutorial when I will show you how we can actually make our random coloured jam tarts. Let's begin. To make the jam we're going to add in a mesh, and the mesh we're going to add in is a cube. I'm just going to scale this cube down by pressing the S key and G and Z just to move it up in the air, just to make it a little bit clearer for our tutorial. Right, what we're going to do is go on the spanner or wrench here, and we're going to add a modifier, and the modifier we're going to add is a subdivision modifier, and we're going to take this right up to 3, which is still quite low poly, and then shade smooth. And then we're going to apply this, but what we've got here is we've got a very low poly cube, and if I just go into edit mode you can see how low poly it is, and the cube, because we've subdivided it, has changed into a ball. So what we're going to do is scale this in the Z until we get a thin disc, and G and Z move this down so it's just above our pastry, and scale this up like that. As you can see, it probably pokes out the bottom there. So you just scale this in the Z just to make it that little bit thinner again, like that. As you can see, there's a little bit of a gap around the edges. So we scale this up until it just reaches the pastry. So we've got the pastry there. And what we're going to do is add in a texture. And we're going to create a new texture. I'm going to call this the jam texture. So I'm just going to rename this jam, J-A-M, like that, and I'm just going to change its color to red. We'll now go on to the shading tab. Make sure you're in rendered mode by hitting the end. If you need to scroll across you can do, but I'm just going to hit the end there. So we've got something there, looks like a bowl of tomato soup or something, but what we want to do is actually make this into a jam type texture, and we're going to do this quite simply by taking the roughness down to 0, which of course makes it very very shiny. Take the metal up slightly, it makes it a little bit more shiny or reflective, and then we're going to take the transmission 2.5. And I'm going to take the alpha 2.5. So we've now got a semi-translucent object because we took the roughness down, so it's smooth. But what we want to do is give it a bit of texture. So, for want of a better word. So we're going to use the bump map to do this. And what we're going to do is add in a shader and the we're going to add in a texture, and the texture is going to be a Musgrave texture. This has got height map information which we can use on our bump node, so I'm going to add in a vector, and the vector is going to be the bump node. And what we can do, you've got a normal on the bump, so we've put the normal into the normal. We can put the actual Musgrave into the height map, so we go height to height, and voila, what we've done is made ourselves a bumpy surface that looks a little bit jam, but not exactly like jam. But you can actually mess about with it if you want it to be really rough like that, or really really smooth like that, and just, you can actually just affect the waves on this, and you can also affect the detail by increasing or lowering the other details. And of course the dimension changes the dimension. That's just how high the waves actually are, and the lacunarity, I think that's how you say it, it's lacunarity, whatever that is, don't know what that does. But you can mess about with that to your heart's content as well if you wish. So we've got ourselves a jam-like material, slightly translucent. And all we're going to do now is just join all these together. So join, join, and join. And I'm just going to join all three together, and we've got our jam tart. As you can see, our camera's lost its way, and that's because it's not pointing at anything now. So I'm just going to go on to the camera's object constraints, and if it's not already added, you can track it to the empty that we created in a previous tutorial. Or alternatively, you can just add in an empty, add in mesh, and you'll find empty just there. So you can add an empty and make the camera point at your empty. So now we've got our jam tart, but you can change the color simply by selecting these. But if you'd like to do it randomly, what you can do is add in a color ramp. So add in, add, converter, color ramp. Make sure you've actually got this selected to constant. And then just hit the plus button here just to add a few different colors. I'm just going to space these out pretty evenly and just change the color. So select that, make it go to bright. I've got a yellow one there. Select the first one. Make it a red. Select this one. Now make it a bluey purple. Now I'm going to make this one in the middle some kind of orange or apricot color. So you've got all these colors, and all we need to do is actually select that into there. And as you can see, it picks the first color. But if you duplicate this, it will still take on the first color. So we actually need to actually add in a random node. And this is found on the input under object info. And if we go location, if we go random and put into the factor, as you can see, if we look from the top now, I'll just back out a little bit. If we were to shift and D to duplicate this, and then G and move it over. So now we've got shift and D. And G, as you can see, is producing shift and D, different color, shift and D, different color jam tart. Just depending, shift and D, on what's randomly generated, like that. Yeah, not very random, you might say. That's things being random, I guess. And then if we actually render that out, wait a few seconds. We've got our various jam tarts. That one's a bit close, so I'm just going to get rid of that and just move it over to one side. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you find it useful, just for making our jam. I wonder what it looks like in Cycles. In Eevee, even. Does it look as good in Eevee? Probably not, but let's just see. Bit more low poly, a bit false looking. Maybe not as good as in Cycles, but still quite good in the distance of a scene, I think you'd agree. Yeah, I think Cycles got the edge on this one. Bye for now.